Hello everyone, my name is Lars Blunt, or Lars Blønd, and I'm going to tell you about the arthroscopic trochloplasty. This patient I'm going to present is a young girl. She had operated the other knee 1 year ago successfully, and now she's going to have an arthroscopic trochloplasty in her right knee based on recurrent patellar dislocation and moderate trochlear dysplasia, as you can see here by her MRI. First of all, we start looking from the suprapatellar punch, that means above the knee, and you see this flat trochlear. Above here you see the patella, the kneecap, and here you see the trochlear. And this radio frequency device is going to take away the synovia above the trochlear. This needs to be done in order to be able to go in with the shaver burr. Here you see the huge trochlear bump. And having taken away the synovia, I'm able to go in with the shaver burr. And this goes into the clivage between the bone and the cartilage. And I need to remove the trochlear bump, and I need to make this cartilage flake. I just go further and further down into the knee until I reach the area where the knee bends. Then I cannot go further down. I also use a chisel. This makes things a little easier, goes a little faster. And I have to say, this is a quite time-consuming procedure. You need to be very careful not to harm the cartilage flake. So you have to be precise. And then you see here now I have reached the area where the knee bends and I'm not able to go further down. And having reached that area, I'm going to make a deeper and more lateralized groove, meaning that the groove has to be more to the outer side. So here I make the trochlear deeper. And having made the trochlear deeper, I need to test out if the cartilage flake is plastic enough to reach the new groove. And I use this device to press the cartilage flake into the new trochlear groove, and you see it fits nicely. Then I'm going to reinsert the cartilage flake to fix it, and I use resorbable anchors. This is the anchor, and it's resorbed within 3 to 5 years. And the anchor is just used to keep those tapes, the blue ones, and the blue tapes are resorbed within 5 to 6 weeks, and then the cartilage flake will have healed back into the bone. I need to drill a hole, and then I place the next anchor above the trochlear. And now you will see how the cartilage flake is pressed into the new groove by this resorbable blue tape. And here comes the anchor. The anchor that fixates the tape. And then I just cut the rest of the tape. Altogether, I use 3 to 4 anchors with tapes and sutures to fix the cartilage flake. In this situation, I have 3 anchors above the cartilage flake. And here it's finished. Thank you.